Good morning. Very welcome on this information session about the part-time master fatality and aging. We know it's early, but the sun is shining, so this is a really good idea. But you are not only from the Netherlands, because if you are outside abroad, maybe you are in the middle of the night. So very welcome on this special session about the part-time master fatality and aging. Today we will introduce to you the program and some details, and we are here together to tell you about. But first, we want to ask you to go to this link that you see in the blue. There you can participate to the chat, and we will ask you a question. And in the chat you can ask all your questions. So type it in. Maybe we will have it answered already in the 45 minutes that will come, and otherwise we will answer during this session. So type in, this is the link, and you will see it on every slide, so I think that's good. But first, we are going to introduce ourselves. I'm Jacobijn Gusseklo. I'm the director of this master program, and I'm a GP by training and professor of primary care in the LUMC, and already for years doing research and education in aging. I really love this topic, and I'm willing to contribute to the best of the lives of older people. So, Iri, you are the next one. Welcome here.
Thank you. I'm Iri Timmer. I am at the moment a junior lecturer at the part-time master. So I'm giving the working groups for the part-time students, and I'm also developing the part-time program. And I also did this master's by myself. So I'm also an alumni.
Thank you.
And Julia?
Thank you. Welcome, everyone. My name is Julia Minema, and I did also the Master of Vitality and Aging myself. And currently, I'm also a junior lecturer of the masters. And besides, I'm also working in research.
So that's really great. So we are with a couple of three very experienced people, but we know the master from the start to the end. I think we go to this slide. So why would you study vitality and aging? There are many reasons to study vitality and aging, but here we have the main reasons. I think it's very a program that learns you, that educates you, that trains you to play a key role in improving the future of our society. The future is about aging. Our population is aging, and I think it is very important that we have academic young professionals that can help, that can contribute to all kinds of disciplines where you can work when you study this master. It's an interdisciplinary program, and you combine the biology of aging, you combine the public health vision and the healthcare management part. So it's not only biology, it's about the people, it's about the society, and you will have everything together to go for solutions and challenges for the future. You will receive an extensive training to increase your personal and professional development. So it's not only important to have knowledge, because with knowledge you cannot change the world. You need really to have your professional and personal development. And we will start in the master on day one till the end, working about what are you going to do in the future. Really interesting, and training your professional and personal academic skills. We have a personalized study method, very small groups, working groups together, and with around 40, 50 students working together for a whole year, you get really a team of peers, a team of colleagues together, and you will find each other later on also. If you go to the details of this program, today we introduce to you our new part-time program. On this moment we have a pilot program, part-time, so next year we will go for official, and it is then a two-year Master of Science program, and it is 60 points, 60 EC points, so that means that you have to study around 20 hours per week, so not full-time, but 50%. The locations will be in Leiden, where we are now, in The Hague sometimes, and a lot of education will also be online, so we have independent of locations you can study this program. The language is English, and the starting date will be September 5th, 2022. And all your applications has to be in before the June 15. So that's the application deadline. And for international students from abroad, very important, please send in your applications before the 1st of April, because you have to do everything with the visa, etc., and the housing. We combine online and on-campus education, very trained, very experienced. So you are dealing again and again with hybrid, with connecting people from abroad, having in the program with all the technical challenges and the very educational innovative methods to have a good hybrid education, combination of online and on-campus. And when we are on-campus, some people could also be online. If you see how our interdisciplinary and international classroom shows, then here you see the ratings and the numbers. So we see here, if you see what the backgrounds are of our students, then 60% is from the medical side. We have also the biomedical and health background, so not doctors but the others, and then the other group. And if you go to the other pie, then you see that we have around 20% of international students and 80% of Dutch students. So an international classroom and an interdisciplinary classroom mixed together. Here you see the overview of your part-time, maybe your part-time program for 2022 to 2024. So it's 2 years. You see here for all months you see the picture. And here you see that you will start with the older individual, then you go to the organization of the aging society, the biology of fertility and aging, and the science and career. These terms you will get know them for the next few minutes because you are going to explain what's in. But here you see so the big modules, but you also see the lines, communication in science, academic development, and research and evidence. And they are going through the whole program for the 2 years, all accumulating at the end in your internship period, and that's the science and career. So this is the program what you will go for if you start in September 2022. This is a week overview, how it's on this moment. So we hope this is also for next year, but this is the plan. So you can do on-demand, online, all your seeing the recording of the lectures. You can go to your module book, all doing all the assessments, assignments. But on the Friday, you have your skills training, your mentoring, your presentations, your lectures with live on campus, synchron, so on the same moment you see each other. But during the whole week further, you can do your work on your own time. Does this mean that you only have to study on the Friday? And I look to Iri. No, you have to do a lot of other work because only the Friday is not enough. So you need some more time in the weekends, in the evenings, to complete the program with around 20 hours a week. I think that's important to know. But then, after 2 years, you have your academic master degree. If you have questions, of course, about all the things, you can type them in by the link that's still on the slide. This program is a part-time program, but it's joined to the full-time program. And here you see the picture, a picture of last year of the graduation. Are you on this picture?
Yes.
Oh, do you see Julia? I see you. You are the second one, huh? So you got your diploma last September. So this was your peer group. How was it to be there with the flowers?
It was great also to finally see my peer students for a very long time because last year, of course, a lot of the education was online. So we mostly saw each other through Kaltura, which is the online classroom that we use. And especially after the internships, it was very nice to exchange our experience and see each other again. So.
It was in the old city of Leiden, in the old
academic building.
So this is, and here you see also the small scale because this is one of the group of the graduation. So you are also a small group of students to work together.
Yeah, you work together in teams of four people and you have a working group of around 12 people. So it's all very small and everyone really knows each other. So that's really great, yeah.
You learn to work together with all kinds of persons and characters and disciplines, I think.
Yeah.
You learn a lot during a year. So this program, so the part-time program is really joined and built on the full-time program. And you will meet the full-time students also in the debates. Today we have a debate with the part-time and the full-time students. They are really working hard on the LUMC, debating, giving presentations. doing excursions. So we hope to go to Brussels this year if COVID gives us the opportunity, and of course the graduation. And the full-time program, if you are interested in that, you can also go back to the session of earlier, and you can find all information. That will be a program about 40 hours per week, and then you have a one-year Master of Science program with, on Monday and Tuesday, online lectures, and on the Thursday and the Friday, all your on-campus lessons. So if you are interested or hesitating, do I want to have the full-time or the part-time, one of a very good question, welcome to discuss. So I'm going to give the floor to Iri.
Yes.
Because you are going to tell something about what is in the courses, and here's the start of biology.
Yep.
But for the part-time program, I saw that's maybe the last.
Yeah, this year the part-time master started with biology of vitality and aging, but for next year you will start with the older individual. But I will first tell you something about biology of vitality and aging.
The basics. Yeah.
Yes. Biology of Vitality and Aging is a course where we will go in depth about how diseases start and how we are aging. So you see a picture on the slide about hallmarks of aging, and the hallmarks of aging are really important in the aging process. And every week we will use a theme to see how we are aging. So we will look into the demography, molecular damage, neuroendocrine systems, environmental cues, animal studies, interventions, and science-based businesses. And every week we will have an assignment, and you will do a presentation, or you will make a video. What are the other assignments we have at the moment?
I think at this moment there was a business plan.
Nice
business plans of new science-based business.
Yes.
So that was, I think, this week. You were there.
So you also work together with a lot of external people. So for instance, this week we cooperate with people from the Leiden Bioscience Park. And last week we cooperated with people from ZON and WE. So that's a grant organization. So I think it's also very interesting to see their opinions.
Yes, thank
so
you.
So not only thinking mm-hmm. about biological hypothesis, but also going to how can I test this hypothesis, and where do I get the money? How can I make business from it? I think
that's
a challenge.
So we have a lot of different assignments every week in the Biology of Vitality and Aging. And for the part-time students, you will have 2 weeks to finish the assignments. And at the end of Biology of Vitality and Aging, you will also write a scientific essay. This is an essay that has to be about biology and the aging process, but you can choose the topic by yourself. So you can really choose a topic of your own interest, and that's really nice. And of course, there will be an exam at the end of this course.
So where do you write your scientific essay about? Do you still know?
It was something about hip fractures and older people, and I think...
Oh, already there your interest in the hip fractures was starting,
so you
will tell later on maybe. Okay, let's go to the next module. Yeah. Is that okay for you?
Yeah, let's do that. So the next module I will tell you something about is the older individual, and that will be the course you will start with if you are going to do this master. The older individual is really about getting to know our population, so the older population. It's a diverse population, and we will go more in depth in the common diseases, self-management, and cultural perspectives. This is the first part of the older individual, and in the second part, we will use this knowledge to create an innovation. So we will get a problem, a common problem in the older population, and they face challenges, and the students will come up with innovations or interventions to solve this problem. So it's really in the second part of the course, you will have lots of co-creation, you will get to know older people, and you will eventually make a video pitch and write a paper about your intervention or innovation.
Okay, and I see here the pictures. So I see Jodi and I see Marieke. But do we have such old students?
No.
Okay, you tell this maybe something about what they are doing together there.
Yeah, on the picture you see a co-creation session. So the two students are talking to one of our older persons from the elderly board. So they are talking about their maybe their intervention if she thinks that fits the population. And of course, last year everything had to go online, so therefore it's a Zoom picture. But hopefully we will do more things at the LUMC in the coming years again.
So they are working together.
Yeah, they are really working together with the older people.
To get your work better.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Exactly.
Yeah. Great, thanks. And the next one.
Yeah.
The first for the part-time.
No, this is the second. Yeah. Okay, for the coming year, this is the second module of the master. And this is the organization of the aging society. This is more a policy course. So we will look at challenges for the economy and the care sector, and you will dive in the Dutch healthcare governance, national healthcare modules, but also international healthcare models, finances and outcomes, managing and changing organizations. And in this course, some lectures will also be in The Hague at the government.
Yeah,
I think.
Public administration.
Yeah. Thank you. And at the end of this course, you will also write a policy brief. So you will dive in a healthcare module. It can be an international healthcare model, and you will write about that.
And here again, you see the co-creation.
Yeah.
With all the people and students together. So I think you will meet 10 times during the program.
Yeah, you will meet a lot of older persons to talk with them and to really get to know them.
And that's because we think that you can only get solutions when you have your clients or your goal group in. So all the people are really working together and help.
Mm-hmm.
And get us a bit stressy maybe sometimes because they are asking a lot and demanding. Yeah. I think that's really great to work together. Okay, then we go to this slide.
Yeah, so I first told you about the big modules, so the knowledge that we are giving you in BVA, OE and OAS, as we call them. But there is also a big part of skills education, as Jacobijn also mentioned before. We have three line courses, communication in science, academic development, and research in evidence. Communication in science is a line course where we want to give you more skills in scientific writing. So I mentioned that there is an essay in BVA course, there is also a paper in the older individual course, and also an policy brief in the Organization of the Aging Society. And through the communication in science line, we will give you more skills in scientific writing. The academic development line is a line that's really focused on your personal development. So there is an individual learning plan. We schedule time for you to really think about something you want to develop by yourself. So maybe for internationals, you can do a Dutch language course, or if you're not that good with SPSS or statistics, you can do an extra statistics course.
Or you can go for voluntary work somewhere.
Or voluntary work.
What you want.
Yeah. Work with the elderly, do something for the elderly. So yeah, you can really choose that by yourself. And then there's also research and evidence, and this is a line where we will prepare you for your thesis. So we will help you to come up with a good research question, to write your thesis plan. And via these three line courses, we will really develop your skills in the education.
Great. And I thought about the communication in science. It's not only writing, because I saw making movies.
Yeah.
Keep having press conferences, everything in.
Yeah.
Movies and latex professional text, English text.
Mm-hmm.
So I think
it's a little bit more than only scientific writing. Yeah. Sorry.
That's an addition. Let's go to the next one. So here we have the skills and professional development. You already told something about.
Mm-hmm.
So I see here the working together.
Yeah.
And the pie with all the parts, so what you are going to do in your mm-hmm. individual learning plan.
Yeah, as we mentioned today, there are the debates. So we also debate. We have lots of interviews with older people. That's also a thing that you can get to know qualitative research. There's lots of cooperation between students, but also between our elderly. There are courses about leadership, how to be a good leader, and also lots of presentations and writing assignments. And we also focus on research because you have to do a research for your thesis. We really try to also focus on the skills and personal development.
Okay. So maybe you want to type in your questions. This is a short moment to think about questions, to type them in, and maybe also to check whether we already have some questions about the first part of the presentation. Okay, we have already some questions. How many contact hours do you have in the part-time program? So that's, I think, Iri, you are currently performing the part-time program. Can you tell about?
Yes, as Jacobijn also mentioned before, we have lectures, working groups, or presentations on the Friday. So for the part-time group, it's really the Friday is the day that you have contact with your peer students, but also contact with your junior lecturer. This year it is me. So I think, there will be, the contact hours are on Friday. It depends on the day, how many contact hours you have. But the Friday is really for the contact with the other students. And during the other days and the weekends, you have to schedule your own time to look at the lectures that are recorded at the full-time master.
Great. So then can you choose something in this master, or is it totally fixed? Is it personalized, the program? Can you tell something about where the personalized thing is?
The program is very personalized. The modules are fixed, so you can't really choose modules, but you are really free to choose within the modules, because within every modules we have assignments. So what Iri already told you, we have an essay, we have an innovation that you have to come up with, we have the policy paper. And for all the assignments, you are able to choose your own topic. And for instance, also your internship, you are freely to choose what you are interested in. And I will tell you more about that.
In maybe
2 minutes, yeah.
So there are, within the fixed program, you have a lot of choices. You're together with the group, make choices or your personalized choices. Yeah. Are there language requirements? Yes, there are language requirements. You have to, if you have a bachelor degree from a Dutch university, then the English is seen as okay. If you don't have a Dutch bachelor degree for the university, then you have to do an English test. Everything is on the website, and with if you pass the test, then you can join in the program. And also for those with applied university, the HBO in Dutch, you can go for this program, but then you have to do the English test unless you have your secondary school English diploma, so from Dutch. So something to discuss. Do I have to come to Leiden to follow this program? Of course, we love to welcome you in Leiden because I think the live education is nice. But at this moment, I think we have just students from abroad who are studying, not coming to Leiden.
Mm-hmm.
So you have internationals in your program who are not going to Leiden.
Definitely. I have at the moment 2 students who are now in Athens. So they are in Greece and they are following all the classes online. And we also have 1 student who lives in Toronto at the moment. So there's also a time difference, but she is also always present at the lectures and the working groups. So you don't have to be in Leiden, but as Jacobijn said, we really love to see you in Leiden. But it's really possible to follow this master's from all over the world.
Yes.
Yeah.
flexible yeah. in place. I think that's great. Okay, thank you for this question. We go further in the program, in our presentation. I will go to the next slide. So now I have some patients. Can you maybe help to switch? Ah, oh. That's great. I think
we have to go a little bit back.
Oh, a little bit back.
Yeah.
This one? Oh, yeah. Julia, you are helping me so good. Thank you for having the overview about the presentation.
Thank you, Jacobijn. Thank you. So now we are already at the final module of the Master Vitality in Aging, and that is Science and Career. And during Science and Career, you will do your internship. And your internship will last for at least 10 weeks. But a side note, that is if you do your internship full-time. So if you want to do your internship part-time, it has to last for at least 16 weeks. And during your internship, you will do research, and besides, you will write your thesis. And what we have talked about already, you can very much choose your own topics as well as your location. So you can do your internship either in or outside the LUMC, but you can also choose to do your internship abroad. And besides, you can do your internship or write your thesis in a topic that you like. And it must be a topic within one of the main courses that Iri explained to you. So you do your internship or your thesis either in the biology of vitality in aging, or in the older individual, or in the organization of an aging society. And now I will give you two examples of internships from last year.
But when I see this range from biology to organization, you can do everything.
You can basically do everything
if you have a scientific question.
Yeah, and as long as it concerns elderly, of course. So this is an internship example from the Netherlands, and this student did her internship at VLANS. And VLANS is a knowledge institute for long-term healthcare in Utrecht, in the Netherlands. And during her internship, she investigated how we can use the concept of positive health and shared decision-making simultaneously to optimize the care for vulnerable older adults. And this was a qualitative study, which means that she conducted interviews as well with healthcare professionals, as well as with prospective expert teams from VLANS itself. And afterwards, she made a recommendation for the implementation of those concepts for VLANS. And this is a great example from an internship for the organization of an aging society. So it's very policy-based.
So policy-based, and you have your academic view, your academic perspectives, and you do your academic work in a really societal important organization.
Yeah, and so you can also very much choose whether you want to cooperate with elderly or whether you want to stay more away from them, because this is more policy-based, so then you are not directly in contact with elderly. But for instance, if you do a more older individual-based internship, then you will be more directly.
And maybe go for interviewing older people.
Yeah.
So this was a qualitative example.
Yeah.
I'm curious what the next example will be.
Yeah.
So, wow.
Yeah, so this is an example of a quantitative study. This is an example of an internship abroad. And this was actually my internship from last year. So I conducted my internship at the BIAM Institute of Primary Healthcare at the University of Bern in Switzerland. So this is very much older individual focus, so very clinically. And during my internship, I investigated the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on the intensity of health services use of older patients in Swiss general practice. So this is a quantitative study. So compared to the previous one, I didn't do interviews. But what I did is I made use of an already existing database, which was made of electronic medical records from approximately 700 Swiss general practices. Unfortunately, due to the COVID pandemic, I was not able to go to Switzerland for most of the time.
So you arranged everything, all the grants, everything was ready.
Yeah, everything was ready. But still, it's very, very valuable to cooperate with people from abroad and yeah, it was still a great experience too.
At the end, you went there.
Yeah, at the end I went there and I was finally able to see my supervisor in real life and the institute in real life. So that was great. Yeah,
that was great. So when the world opens, you can go again. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so this was your internship.
Yeah. So then, what's also very important, what are the possibilities after the program, after the Master of Vitality in Aging? Well, there's a lot of preparation during the program, so we organize a lot of orientation visits. So for instance, we plan to go to the ministry, but also to the municipality or to nursing homes, so that you can really have an inside look into the possibilities. What are most alumni doing after the master? Approximately one third works in policy, one third works in research. So for instance, they start a PhD trajectory, and one third is pursuing a medical career. So they start with their rotations. So what are examples? A lot of people go, for instance, work at the Ministry of Health, Welfare and Sports. We have quality staff in nursing home organizations, so that's very policy-based. So if you like the organization of an aging society. So a lot of people go for a PhD or they continue their Master of Medicine.
If you want to continue with your Master of Medicine, then of course you also have to have your Bachelor of Medicine. Because you cannot become a doctor in our program. It's an additional to the medical program.
Yeah.
I think that's important to know.
Mm-hmm.
So, and is it easy to find a job?
It's quite easy to find a job. I already
you had your job already before your graduation.
But as it is listed, most professionals find a suitable job within 3 to 6 months after their graduation. And a lot of people, for instance, talk to lecturers afterwards to already make connections. It's a very small world, so I think most people don't really have a hard time finding a job.
So you had a job in the corona business.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you had also very soon a job after your graduation.
Yes.
But now you are back to the Vitality
Now I'm back to Vitality and Aging.
Yeah. Okay, here I see some alumni in the academic building writing their sign on the wall, the famous wall in the Tweedkamertje.
In the academic building. Yeah, so here you see two alumni. You see Dorine, she is doing a PhD trajectory at the moment, more policy-based. And besides, you see Suzanne, and she is a policymaker in a nursing home. So there are a lot of different possibilities after the master program. And what's interesting is that they also give a presentation during the master program to tell you something about their work. And to really give you an inside view in the career possibilities after the master.
During the program, you will also meet the alumni.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Good if you have questions. Okay, so this is a big list.
Yeah, so also very important, how do you get into the Master of Vitality in Aging? If you have a health-related bachelor at the university, you are freely admissible. So for instance, if you have done medicine, biomedical sciences, health and life sciences at the VU University, then you are freely admissible. However, if you have not a health-related bachelor, please do not hesitate to contact us because there are a lot of possibilities to still get into the master's program. However, then you will be evaluated by the admittance committee. And they will look at your educational background as well as your work experience. So they will look, for instance, at your experiences with research or biology. So also students who went to the University of Applied Sciences and did education in the health domain are very encouraged to please sign up and contact us. Only international students do need an English test.
And those with applied sciences. Without the VWO diploma.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, but if you have questions, just ask it. I think that's really good, doable.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go to the next slide. This is about application.
Yeah, so please apply before the 15th of June in 2022 via StudyLink. But for the international students, please do it before the 1st of April. This is because of visa and other regulations.
So, and There was something about selection and maximum, but this year we will not have selection. There is no maximum. So everything who is in application and who fulfills the criteria, you can start. So don't be, don't have to wait for selection or all kinds of things. Everything is, everyone is very welcome. No selection anymore. Ah, here we have our students from Athens.
Yes, yes, Spiro, this is a student that's in my working group at the moment, and we asked him if he wanted to tell something about his experiences at the moment.
So can you start the movie?
Yeah. Hi everyone and welcome to LUMC. This is Spiro, one of the first students that have enrolled in the part-time Masters of Vitality and Aging. I will attempt to give you an insight into the program. It will take 2 years to complete these masters. Practically, an academic year is divided into two semesters, so there are four semesters. Each semester you attend a core module in which you will give an exam in the end. The final semester is the internship and thesis. The rest of the modules will give you the knowledge and skills needed for completing the core modules and your thesis. Whatever you learn is linked. There are individual and group assignments, and most of them are not similar to each other. For instance, so far we have made various presentations, a poster assignment, videos, we've given feedback or written an abstract. I'm looking forward in a few weeks from now that I will give a presentation on a business idea with an intervention. Our workload is the same with that of the full-time students, but it's spread into 2 year time. From Monday to Thursday, we can watch our video lectures whenever we can. On Fridays, there's compulsory online attendance. We review what we have seen on the video recordings, ask questions, attend online lectures on other subjects, and make presentation. This part-time master's is what I prefer to call a flexible master's. I have the chance to work and study at the same time, which makes things easy in terms of my finances. Moreover, you don't have to commute. Maybe on Fridays, it depends. So you don't have to move close to Leiden. You can be anywhere in the Netherlands or the globe. For example, I can attend this course even if I live 3.5 hours away by plane from Leiden. I'm currently in Athens. However, I have the chance to participate almost in everything fully online. I even took part in a pub quiz on the introduction day through Skype. Don't get me wrong, I value personal contact and on-site attendance. But until this is possible, I consider myself lucky that I have the opportunity to attend the Master of Vitality and Aging fully online. Using the university app through my mobile and computer, I can check my schedule, upload assignments, download literature, and do so much more. It makes everything easy. For example, on Fridays when I have classes, I'm only a click and a couple of seconds away from the next class. Moreover, we have several WhatsApp groups so we can effectively and easily communicate with each other. As you already assume, my experience so far is very positive, not only because of flexibility, but also because of the personalized study methods. Another word I would like to describe these masters is personal. This is personal. You have the chance of good education in a private setting. Your tutors know who you are. They're very approachable. Response time is quick and classes are small. When you make a question, you always get an answer. On top of that, your opinion matters. Our tutors are here to offer help. It's been only a couple of months since I started this master's, so professionally, I like to keep an open mind and explore any possibilities that might turn up during this program. It could be research, policy, or something that I haven't considered yet. Before I say goodbye, I would like to ask you, when you see a photo of an older person, what do you think? Ask yourself. Well, 2 months ago, I would think just the obvious, the image of the photo. But now, when I see a photo of an older person, I think of interventions. What interventions could I employ to improve the person's life? Could these interventions be in terms of biology, society, policy? If you think like how I do now and you want to contribute in order to help the older individuals in our society, then these masters might be what you're looking for. You will have the chance to explore the mechanisms that contribute to aging. Also, if you're looking for a program that gives you the time and flexibility to work or take things slow at the same time, this is something you might also want to consider. I hope that I managed to give you an idea about the part-time Masters of Vitality and Aging. If you have any questions, feel free to type them in the chat. I will be glad to answer them. Thank you for your time, good luck with your studies, and goodbye.
So after this inspiring talk about how it is to be in the program and why it's important from our student from Athens, I think we go to the next slide, because of course this is maybe the start of your information or your orientation, or maybe you did already look for our Instagram or our website, everything is maybe on, but you can have some next steps if you want to orientate even more. So today you can chat with students and staff. You can find the link somewhere else. And of course, we have more methods to get known each other and to have your questions. On November the 29th, there will be an online experience day. So then you will get some lessons. So how is it to be in the program, but then special organized for new people who want to orientate for this master program. A next step, or even maybe your first step, will be to apply for to be a student for a day. You can then sign up by this email address, and then you can participate for one day with the education. And if you want, you can choose an online day, so that's the Monday and the Tuesday, or part of that, and then you get everything, the links, and you can participate. Or you come to the university on Thursday and Friday, Thursday or Friday, or you participate to the part-time program on the Friday when there is live education. Mm-hmm. That would be nice. So please feel welcome and send us an email and what you want to participate, and then we will list you in. I think the next slide is about questions. Do we have more questions? So I think this is a good question. Julia, is the diploma for part-time and full-time the same?
Yeah, for both the part-time and the full-time program, you will receive 60 ECs. So that's a Master of Science degree. So it's the same. The only difference is that the full-time will take 1 year and the part-time will take 2 years.
So and the tests and everything is the same. Yeah. You have more time and you have maybe another type of colleagues, because we expect that in the part-time program there will be more, maybe more professionals. Mm-hmm. And in the full-time students, that may be another group. So, but the diploma is exactly the same.
Yeah.
What are the career perspectives? No, I think we already told something about, so what can you do? So one-third is going to research, one-third of our students is going to policy making in a very broad working field of fertility and aging. And one-third is going further with their medical career. So doctors who are in the program are going to do their doctor work again, and so they can make a step in the academic level. So I think there's a lot of inspiration for that. You can also see on the website some alumni stories. And if you have more questions about for your own questions about career perspectives, please feel free to chat with the staff after this session. So how is a regular part-time VNA week? I think we told already, we saw this schedule, and you wanted to tell that not only the Friday is enough.
No, and I think we can combine a little bit the three questions, because a regular VNA week, for the part-time students, regular in the week is that you have to be present on the Fridays, so then you have class, and all the other hours you can make a schedule by yourself, because you have to look back the lectures. There's not a really regular VNA week for the part-time students, as we showed the or as we told the week for a full-time student. It is really possible to combine the program with a part-time job. All the students at the moment have a job next to the part-time master, so they have to struggle a little bit because it's something new you're doing, but they really like the opportunity to follow this master next to their job. Talk in the chat with one of the part-time students about combining the program with the job. The average hours, I think Jacobijn also talked about it already. I think it's approximately the 20 hours we told you. Take that into account when you maybe start this part-time master's program.
Okay, maybe shall I tell something to how to combine this master program with your medical internship or your medical school? But because we see that a lot of students want to combine the Master Fertility and Aging with their medical school, within their medical school, sometimes in the wachttijd, so between the bachelor and the master program, because we know that due to COVID, the waiting time is very long. So then maybe you have the possibility to go for the full-time program if you have a waiting time of 1 year, and then you can combine parts of the both studies and you will for sure have two master diplomas. And you can also do it next to the co-schappen, so that's the Master of Medicine, but you also can do it next to another program. But then we see that this master program is really a master program where you have to act every 2 weeks. You have to do things. It's not that you can take a half year and then say, okay, I'm going to study for 2 weeks. You have to be able to do things on the moments that they are planned. So if you have a very lazy co-schappen and it's not or another master where you don't have to be on time, on schedule, then maybe you can combine. But if you want to combine with your co-schappen or if you want to combine to other things, I think it's really important to have some discussion with our study advisor and with the staff. It's doable, it's plannable, but in this individualized program, we can help you how to combine. So if you want to do this challenge, please go into the chat, have contact with us, because I think that's very important. Mm-hmm. I think this is the last question about the combination of two masters. We know we have a lot of students with ambition, and two masters, of course, is good. So maybe you can also do it after each other and have a period in between where you do two together and you don't have to start with two new ones. So let's go back to the slides. Yeah, I think these were the questions. It's really great. And then we are here still. We are in Leiden, but of course you can connect us in all kinds of ways. So I like really this picture because it was when the world was going open, so I think around April. So it was the first time that those students saw each other after a long period. So in the old city of Leiden. So that was a great moment, I think. And if you want to contact the staff, the junior members, junior lecturers, or you want to chat with our student ambassador, you can go by the Unibody, or you can send your email to studentambassador@lumc. You can also plan a call. You can plan a call with the staff, with the students, and then you can use this email address. And if you have questions about combining programs, about finances, about tests for English, about housing, also the study advisor can help you. And also maybe when you have limited energy or a chronic disease and you want to study this program, our study advisor can help you how to combine your personal life with this part-time program. So and don't be afraid to send just an email to mastervna@lumc.nl, because everyone will be spread to the wide one. So we are really looking forward to see you somewhere live or online on the chat, because then we can come into contact and help you and inform you and discuss about your future. Because a future is important for all the people, but also for you as a student who wants to contribute to the aging society. I think we can finalize here. Thank you for coming. And we are really looking forward to welcome everyone.
Yes.
So thank you for joining this session, and we hope to see you later on. Thank you.